Good morning, YouTube. Back out in the garden shed. So I ran into one problem with this Harbor Freight solar fan controller. It doesn't have a low voltage disconnect feature. It'll shut off maybe 4 or 5 volts where the logic chips inside stop working. But I ran into some problems where we get hot weather but overcast, and it's hot enough that the fan controller here stays running, but it'll discharge the batteries down to around 10 volts. So I had picked up a couple of these charge controllers. They're listed as a 20 amp MPPT charge controller, and I'd been running this one for a while and it quit. I think it's got a problem with the internal power supply, because it would kind of run, but as soon as you turned on the external load, it would quit, just blank out, and then after a while it would reset. And so I put the second one, I picked up two of these, and I'll do a separate video where I look inside and show you that these are not MPPT, they're just PWM charge controllers. So I've decided to finally get a real MPPT charge controller. So I picked up one of these, an EPEVER Tracer AN, and this uses the same remote as my main charge controller on the lithium. So this way I get a spare meter if I need that, or I can use all the like the Wi-Fi interface or any of those things that work there. I've got a spare of that. And this is much more than I need. It's 20 amps. And the most I'm probably going to see there is maybe 3 amps. But I also wanted to check this out because I'm wanting to put a charge controller and solar panel in my Toyota 4Runner. And I'm looking for a decent charge controller to put in there. I've got a 200 watt panel. That's what I was hoping these were going to be. That's why I picked up two of them. But I don't think I'm going to use those. So I figured I would get one of these and try it out up here. Two things I need to do. One is I've got to reconfigure the solar panels to put them in series, give me about 40 volts open circuit, since I can now use that higher voltage with an MPPT charge controller. And then the other thing I've done over here on my battery bus bars is, now that I have a load output, I've split my three power jacks here, which are for the outside light, the inside light, and then I power the Harbor Freight fan controller off of the load. So I'm going to have these three outputs plus an extra set of wires here powered off of the load output of the charge controller. Then I've got the battery section separate. So I've got battery, load, and then my solar panels. We'll get this out of here and then see about getting the Tracer AN installed. Okay, there we go, YouTube. Got the charge controller in. Plugged in my remote monitor here. You can see that. So right now we're getting about 5 watts coming in. A little after 10 in the morning, so we're not doing a lot there. Let's see, on the load here, I'm going to turn on one of my lights. Let's see if that shows up. 0.9 amps, 11 watts for my LED light over there. But yeah, so now I've got my battery is plugged in here, and that goes into the banana jack. So I've got three sets of banana jacks up there for the battery connections, my two batteries, and then the charge controller. And then I have an extra lighter socket there if I need to plug something in off of the accessories here. I've got my fan, inside light, and outside light. I'll probably make up another lighter socket and plug that in here. So on the Harbor Freight fan controller, all I've done is hooked the battery input for the controller over to my accessory load. So that way, if the voltage drops too low, the power to this thing is shut off. And it still works as a fan controller. Let's see if I turn the temperature down there. Yeah, now the fans are on. There's the load, 0.4 amps, if you can see that there. So I've got the fans on, and if I go back up, turn them off, and that should drop to zero. There we go. You know, this is way overkill for what I need in here, because I've only got 30 watts of panel, but I want to get that in here, try this out, because if this works well, I might get another one of these and put it in my truck, because I've got 200 watt solar panel that I want to put on the roof of the truck, and I would need something like this to run that. And maybe in the shed here, maybe I'll throw a couple of extra panels up here on the roof. Because one thing I had been trying to do here, if you can see those two screws in the wall, I had my Craftsman battery charger in here, and I was trying to run that off of the batteries in here. And for some reason, these charge controllers just didn't like that. Seemed to be some sort of problem again with the power supply, because as soon as I would turn on the Craftsman battery charger up there, plug it in, these things would turn off. You would see the screen go blank and then it would quit charging. I'll see how it works for a couple of days, and then I might bring my Craftsman battery charger back in here, because that way it gives the shed some more work to do. When I convert my main system over to lithium batteries, I'll keep this set up as a 12 volt system in here, and that Craftsman battery charger runs off of 12 volts. So I might as well have it in here running off of 12 volts rather than on the lithium batteries. I'll need to get a step down converter for that. But yeah, I'll keep you updated how this is working after a few days, see how it fares out here. And also, this should be a pretty good test with the heat, because it'll get rather warm in here, so I want to see how this does with a little higher heat. Now, I have the fans. They're set to turn on about 95 Fahrenheit. Might turn the fan thermostat down a little bit later, but this should simulate the kind of temperatures you'd get in the truck if it's sitting out in the sun in a parking lot or out camping in the desert. So I want to see how this guy does in the heat. And ideally, I'd like to run it without a fan. And with this one, I'm only putting, you know, maximum 30 watts into it, so it shouldn't get hot. But yeah, I'll keep you updated how this is working. Check out some of the other videos over here on the left side. And any questions, you can post up in the comment section down below here. Subscribe to the channel for more content like that with that button. And as always, thanks for watching.